Hello learners, now we are going to continue the AA with the second lecture in order to learn types of the agent system. Before enter into the types of agent system, we must understand what is the agent program and one example agent program. Then we slowly move to what are the types of agent system available and advantage of each agent system and architecture for all the agent system. First, we start with what is agent program. So, job of the AA to design an agent program. Actually, it is a mapping from the percept to action. All the agent function we are going to implement through the algorithm. To implement this algorithm, we need a physical architecture. For example, we want to implement the action called a walk. We need an architecture that should support the physical component called the legs. So all the agent program we call it as the combination of all the agent is a combination of architecture plus the corresponding program. So we have to write the agent program from the agent function, which is a mapping of percept to action, and the supporting architecture. These two forms the complete agent system. First, we start with one simple agent program for a table-driven agent. This is a table-driven agent. We create one big table to represent the agent function. On the left-hand side, we have the percept sequence. Right-hand side, we write the corresponding action for the percept sequence. For example, we take the vacuum cleaner bowl. The percept sequence is A, clean. Then the agent has to execute the action called the right side move in order to check the B state, whether it is in the cleaned state or in the dirty state. Same way, if the current square A in the dirty condition, we are going to apply the operation called the suck. This is an example for agent function which contain all possible percept sequences. For all possible percept sequences, the action recommended by the agent system is written in the right side column. Now we'll check what is the work of table driven agent. We already seen the structure of the agent program. Function is a reserved keyword. The name of the algorithm always written in uppercase, table driven agent. The input argument is nothing but the percept. It returns the action. We have two variables. One is nothing but percepts, another one is nothing but the table. Percepts is a sequence. Initially, it is empty. Table represents the table of action indexed by the percept sequences. Initially, all possible entries are fully specified in the table structure. What is the working style of the agent? Whenever it gets a percept, it appends the percept to end of the percept history and look up the percepts in the table structure. The corresponding action it look up and store the action into the action variable. The stored action variable will be written as return type for the execution of the agent function. What is the drawback with the table driven agent? If the environment is very simple, then it is no problem. But you consider the situation like an automated taxi driver. For every second, we have to take 30 frames. For example, you have to create the lookup table up to 10^2500 entries for an hour driving. This is a very big challenge for the AI to create the vast table and pick up the rational behavior from the vast table. In order to avoid that, the entire agent system, we are going to divide in a different category, what is called a type of agent system. There are four types under the agent program. First one is simple reflex agent. Second one is model based agent. Third one is goal based agent system. Fourth one is utility based agents. First we start with simple reflex agent. By the name, you understand that it's simply reflecting the percept to the action. Actions always based on current percept. The agent system going to ignore the rest of the percept history. So all the action initiated by the agent will follow if then rule. If the car in front of me is braking, Then I have to execute the action called the initiate the braking. So what is the drawback of the simple reflex? We are not bothering about the perceptive history. We will check the architecture for this simple reflex. Consider this is an environment, whether the vacuum cleaner or automated taxi driver, maybe the road signal, traffic, pedestrian. So the structure of the agent, either the program or a physical taxi driver, we will get all the percepts through the sensors. It's stored in a state called what the world is like now. Then I have a set of rules stored in a knowledge base, recommended actions. It will match the percept with the corresponding action. From the rule, it choose one action that I perform through my actuators. Actuator will react to the environment. What is the drawback of the simple reflex method? Simple reflex method only suitable for the environment which is fully observable. For example, we have only one camera in the front side to get the single frame. That is not sufficient to initiate the braking. Unfortunately, older models have different configuration of the light in different location. So it is not always possible to tell from a single image whether the car has to initiate the braking or it has to stop. So the simple reflex agent always has to either brake continuously or unnecessarily. Same way for a vacuum cleaner world, we have two type of sensors. One is to locate the location, second is to identify the dirt. If either one of the fail, then the action by recommended by the agent system won't be optimistic. To avoid that, we move to the new model, what is called a second type of agent system. It's nothing but the model based agent. So most effective way to handle the partial observability, we keep track of what the world around us, what we can't see now, that I maintain by name called as an internal state. Each time I get the information, I'll update this internal state. The internal state information contains two data. One is nothing but we need some information about how the world evolves independently of the agent. We need some information about how the agent own affects the world. So without me, how the agent look like, with my action, what is happening in the world, the two datas we are going to keep track that guides me to move in an optimistic path. We see the architecture for the model based agent. This is the environment. The change from the previous diagram to this one, instead of the space, we have three more information. One is nothing but the internal state. Another two information is how the worlds evolve without agent system. With my action, what is happening in the world, these two information I am feeding once again back to what is the world like now. That changes the internal state. That complete percept I am feeding into the action list. The action list is influenced by the condition action rule. The recommended action will be forwarded to the actuator. Through the actuator, it will perform the action to the environment. Now the problem with the model based reflex agent, we are not focusing on what is our goal state. We slowly moving from the left to right, right to left and go straight on. We are not focusing on where is our destination. We will check the algorithm also. Function is a keyword. Model based reflex agent is the name of the algorithm. Percept is the input argument. Return type is a returns an action. We have four variable. One is nothing but the state. State describes about the current conception of the world. Model describes about how the state depends on the current state as well as the action. It's nothing but the next state. Rules describes about the condition action rule that we already followed for the simple reflex model. Action is the most recent action. Initially it is none. So instead of taking the percept as the current input, we are updating the state by using update state function call. We passing four argument. One is nothing but the state current world description. Action which was agent implemented in the recent time, the perceived the current situation. The model is nothing but the description of the next state based on the current state and action. This four data helps me to update my internal state that's stored in a variable called a state. After that, I'm going to match this state to the rule set. Which percept is matching with the state, that rule we are going to pick it up. That rule action I'm going to implement in the action variable, that going to return as the return type. Change from the previous reflex to the model based agent system. Instead of getting the only one percept, we taking the previous model history as well as the previous state situation percept and the action we recently performed. Anyway, this is not optimistic to reach my goal state. So we slowly move to the third type of the agent system, what is called a goal based agent. So what is the goal based agent? Knowing something about the current state of the environment is not always enough to decide what to do. For example, the taxi can turn left, right and go straight on, but the current decision only depends on where the taxi is trying to get to. So that describe only by using goal information. That's nothing but the which are the actions are desirable to agent system. We'll check the architecture. So change from the previous model based agent to goal based agent. We have one more box, what is called a what will be the like if I do the action A. So I am updating one more state, the percept what I received and the action I am doing is likable by the agent system. Then the instead of a condition action rule, I am going to use a goal. So each time I pick one action, I am checking whether the action is close to my goal state. Now the problem is that goal is a fuzzy term. We may have so many goals that are nothing but sub goals. Some may be satisfied by the agent system, some may not be satisfied by the agent system. To describe, I reached a certain level, instead of a goal, you can divide the goal as a sub goal. Each sub goal can be described by the utility factor. That we call as a utility based agent. Goals alone not enough to generate high quality behavior in most of the environment. For example, we want to achieve the goal state with a safer, quicker, more reliable or cheaper. Then the goal just to provide the binary distinction between happy and unhappy. We need a general performance measure to compare what is the level we obtain. For example, we can obtain the goal state with a safer node and the cheaper mode, but not in the quicker mode. Then I can describe my goal state in terms of utility function that gives me more flexibility and learning steps. We will check the architecture for utility based agent. Instead of the goal state, I change the goals as utility and add one more state here. After applying the utility function, how happy the agent will be in such a state, that gates me to choose an action, that action deliver to the actuator, then the action will be carried to the environment. All the remaining works are same as my goal based agent. You will get the input from the environment through the sensors, and the state updated based on the previous internal state, how the world evolves without the agent system, and what are the actions I am doing in the agent system, and both the information will pass to the world state as well as what I do, how I will be like in that action list. Then that the information will be forwarded to the next state. The next state is influenced by the utility. Then the close to the utility, if I am happy, then the recommended action will be forwarded to the actuator. Then the actuator will implement the action in the environment through the agent program. So these are some types of agent system. There are some specific application of agent programs mostly discussed in your textbook, Stuart Russell book, what is called a problem solving agent and what is called a learning agent. We will check the problem solving agent and learning agent in next lecture. Thank you.